StudyItOnline.com.
And we are joined by Rob Schneider.
Who needs his own sports show, by the way.
I'm ready for it, man.
Yeah,
you
dude.
Are ready. You're 100% ready.
But, it's just great to be in a real sports town, you know.
Dude, we love it. You know, the only thing.
Better than hanging out in, like, Tampa Bay where people, you know.
Yeah, don't we have a football team?
Well, do you live in L.A. normally?
I live in L.A., which is great because you don't have any football team there. So you can just really be a fan.
Yeah.
Right.
You can get all the teams. You don't have to worry about
it. And no one's from L.A., which is cool. So you have all the different teams.
Yeah, there are some people.
Do you like
it
as a sports town or you hate it as a sports town?
They're a crystal meth addicts, the ones who live.
or a Gyllenhaal.
Or they don't speak English. Yeah.
Yeah.
But is it a good sports town for in your eyes or a crappy one?
I think it can be. I mean, I find like the baseball fans to be, you know, fickle, but, you know, some of them are really knowledgeable because you have like some transplanted New Yorkers out there.
Yeah,
right.
But also, you know, the Dodgers up until their, you know, that McCourt disaster.
Meltdown, yeah.
Yeah. But they had like, you know, a real consistency because you had like, they had three managers over, you know, 35 years.
Yeah.
Do you go to the stadium?
That's consistency. Yeah.
Tell us the deal about the stadium. I heard it was overrun by gangs.
Well, no, it's not true. I mean, I will say like, you have some of the nicer fans you'll have in all of baseball will be at the, believe it or not, at Dodger Stadium. There is a section of it that can get a little tough. And what happened is they were cutting back on security. And also,
right. Yeah.
When the teams stink, it tends to bring out some nasty fans.
Yeah.
And yeah. They cut off at the sixth inning for a reason.
Yeah.
You don't need to be drinking in the seventh, you know, especially
right.
if you're behind by eight or nine. So, but I think that they've got a decent nexus. I just can't believe that that's a $2 billion team. That's how much money it is. Just to give you guys an idea.
Well, that's the TV market.
The TV, not just the TV, the .com. You know, each team now, because of MLB.com, gets $60 million per team. Did you know that?
No, MLB. I did. .com. I knew that.
Yeah, that's just absolutely ridiculous.
It's incredible.
So it's like, you know, so there's no excuse for why the Pittsburgh Pirates can't keep a guy.
Yeah.
You know, that's why they can't keep the guy that they lost to the Blue Jays. They should be able to keep him.
Listen, we've been talking about sports for an hour. I want to talk about Rob Schneider and all the great movies and
Baltimore
hilarious stuff.
Baltimore Comedy Factory.
You know, I just caught an old young comedian special.
Oh, wow.
That you were tremendous on, man.
Well, thank you. I really was, I started out as a stand-up. It's nice to do it again. Chris Rock talked me into doing it, and I'm glad he did. But it was just...
getting back into it?
Well, you have to do it nothing but that. I mean,
right.
I've done nothing but stand-up for the last 3 years. I performed in India, Singapore, Australia.
Oh, my.
So you have to be... I'm an international act. But the thing is, I'm a total normal stand-up. Like, you go see my act, I'm just like, I tell jokes about my... About women, about mostly women, you know, mostly.
Hey.
And being 40. But, you know, I do... My wife, you know, she
has her own credit card.
She's doing okay, yeah. She's got the Christian Louboutin shoes.
Yeah, she's okay with it.
I said, where'd you get those shoes? I don't know. TJ Maxx? I don't know. What? No, I don't think so, honey.
Who made you want to do comedy?
Well, when I was a kid, you know, I mean, we had comedy albums. We had like...
Yeah,
my dad
too.
Didn't have like music albums. We had comedy albums. So he had like Bob Newhart, Nichols and May.
Oh, how great is that?
He had Pete Barbuti, Woody Allen, and then by the time, George Carlin came around and Richard Pryor and Cheech and Chong. I mean, when I was a kid, I bought
boom.
A Cheech and Chong Bing, but it was a gigantic rolling paper. I got to do a TV series with him last year, Cheech, you know, and so, I mean, those guys were legendary. I mean, just to hear the stories about how Dave's not here, man.
Yeah.
Just to hear, he was locked him out, and I guess it was the Warner Brothers. They were, you know, he'd locked him out, knocked him out of the room, and he's knocking to try to get back into the room.
Yeah.
Who Dave's not here. Hey, it's me, man.
Yeah.
And I just laughed my ass off when I was a kid.
Oh, yeah.
So that's what that was.
Did the Eddie Murphy thing grab you at all?
Well, Eddie Murphy, I'm an older guy, so it's like, for me, it's like Eddie was just a knockoff of Richard Pryor. He never got a chance to develop.
Yeah.
As a stand-up.
Because he became such a huge movie star.
Right. I mean, at 19, you're not going to have this, you know, the things. By 22, you need to be in your 30s. Like, you see the difference between Louis C.K. now and 15 years ago.
Oh, it's night and day.
Yeah. Life experience,
completely different man.
Yeah. You got to get beaten down by life. It's just the morning radio. You know, you got to get, get up at 3 o'clock in the morning for 5 years, and then you turn into something if you still want to do it.
Yeah.
Because you can't doubt yourself anymore.
Right.
And that's what you got to have. So... I heard a rumor, because Chris Rock told me, that Eddie's going to go out and start doing stand-up.
Yeah.
And he'll probably be great. But you need to, like, you know, I mean, like, I talk about being in your 40s, the difference between being in your 40s and being in your 20s, you know, and that's, like, a really fun part of my act. Yeah. Just hearing that. You know, the difference between you're in your 20s, you're...
Right.
Hey, we got to get in there, man. Hey, there's some chicks over there. Do you know the doorman? And if you, the difference in your 40s, you hear... Turn that crap down! I'm trying to put on my sweatpants. You know, so it's just... It's fun to hear, because a lot of the guys who come see my act or whatever, they're you know, they're older too. They saw me when they were in college on Saturday Night Live, when I was on Saturday Night Live. Yeah. So
were you one with Norm?
Yeah, Norm McDonald here.
Dude, I got to tell you the best story
ever.
Hey,
yeah, Norm.
He's a little crazy.
So Norm,
he is a little nuts. Norm, I love him though.
Norm, so do I. Norm,
he's a genius.
I'm shooting a documentary right about depression inside a stand up.
Oh wow!
And I interview Norm.
Sounds
oh
funny.
My God!
It's the great. I already here's the beauty.
Hey, let me tell you.
Well,
man.
Listen. The
hey.
Second he's the second interview I did, but I know for a fact he has the last line in the documentary.
Oh yeah.
Because I go, Norm, what do you hate about stand up? He goes, it doesn't matter. I go, what? He goes, everybody takes it so serious. Who cares? Yeah. Telling stupid effing jokes. I go, you don't think stand up matters? He goes, no. I go. A couple maybe loses a mother and father on a Monday. They go out Saturday night just to feel better, and you make them laugh for an hour and a half. That doesn't mean anything. He goes, that doesn't mean anything to me. I don't give an F about them.
Yeah.
Absolutely beautiful. And I ask him
point
blank.
But you have to have the distance, though, because here's the deal. Here's
no, you do, right.
Here's what you're not healing. Like, every comedian, if you've done it long enough, has gotten... You have to. It comes at a price.
No question.
And the one thing, Oxford University wanted to interview me, and I declined.
Right.
Because I'm not interested in talking about it. But I will say, you know, right now, it comes at a price to your psyche. Because you
and
have
your
to
soul.
You have to put yourself out there.
No question.
And then what you put out there, it does seep in sometimes. You
no
know,
doubt.
What's happening. And you have to kind of have a steely, I mean, I have like a physical place on my body where this crowd is not going to affect me no matter what.
Yeah.
When I walk away, I walk away from it.
Of course.
And I don't carry any of it with me. But the thing is, you have to also be human. You have to. Oh, but there's a thing, too. You have to. I'm there to perform and entertain them.
Yes.
So there's that thing where, like, I can't let them destroy me, but, like, at the same time, I want them to have a good time. But I've never been in that as good a place where I, every time I perform now, I'm really put it all out. I've never done that before.
Well, do you feel.
I used to, like, just.
Do you feel
disdain
more.
Disdain for the audience.
Well, it's funny that you say that, but do you feel now that you've had such success in movies, and you've become this, you know, this pop icon kind of guy that everybody knows and loves, that when you walk on stage now...
It gives you an instant credit, yeah, but for 2 minutes. Seinfeld says that.
Yeah, of course.
Seinfeld, you got maybe, you know, if you're famous, maybe you get a minute, maybe two. But then after that, you got to be funny.
Yeah.
These people paid 65, 70 bucks. You know, this is a Seinfeld concert. I'm like, I try to keep my prices as low as I can, because I'm not really doing it for the money. I'm just doing it to get really good at this, and then I do theaters or whatever. But
to
be good at it, you got to be in clubs. You got to do 5 shows a week
against hostile audiences,
and you got to earn it.
Yeah, I agree.
And then it's like not everybody has seen my movies. You know, some of the younger kids will come with their dads or whatever. You know,
yeah.
And so you have to earn it. But
you're the funniest guy in America.
Oh well, thank you. Well, I do have to feel like I got to earn it each joke, and I'm getting there, because the thing is about it is you got to just pummel them. It is an aggressive form of stand-up's a form of aggression. But I think it's aggression, but it's also can be some, if you love it, and some love in it, it's good.
It's there's therapeutic, some guys like, man.
Yeah, like,
I would kill people if
Anthony,
I didn't have the stage.
Look at a guy like Anthony Jeselnik. He's a guy who's trying, and Tosh Ayo. These are both great stand-ups.
Agreed.
These two guys, both these guys are probably, you know, the most interesting comics out there right now.
Yep.
Tosh Ayo, like, tortures the audience, tries to push them, tries to get them angry. Try it. But if you know that's the thing, that's the thing.
Right.
It's exciting.
Yeah.
It's like a boxing match, you know? You know the guy's trying to pummel you, and you got to defend yourself. And the same thing with Anton Jeselnik.
I love that guy.
He's just so, I mean, he will just try to offend you.
Yeah.
And if you just know that's the thing.
Right,
I mean,
if you're there and you're in on the, if you're in on
if
it.
If you're in on
it,
the joke, he's brilliant.
The hell
I mean,
out of
it was
me.
The same, it was, a, you know, I remember 1985 going to see Sam Kinison. With my girlfriend at the time, was this really hot dancer, and I remember
Sam Steeler from you.
She went. I saw him the night before when he came into town, just coming to the comedy club, and he was with a couple of hookers and some Jack Daniels, and two hookers, and I went, I love this guy,
right?
You know, and then I went and I saw him perform at a smaller club, and then he's going to his paid gig, and I went there with my girlfriend, and she just like, she knew she was going to be offended, and she knew she was going to walk out, and that's what some people do, you know?
Yeah, of course.
Just like they did to Lenny Bruce. This is offensive. It's like, come on, no it isn't.
Yeah.
You knew what you were going to get
have
into.
Have you ever?
But that's how hot she was, I walked out with her. What a wuss. I know. That's what an a-hole.
You just lost all comedy cred ever.
Let me tell you.
Yeah.
That's how hot she was, and that's how whooped that was. I mean, that was the thing. Like,
was
at that time,
it?
That was more important than comedy.
Was it worth it, though, when you
absolutely.
Went home? Did you get some? Yeah.
Absolutely.
All right, more with Rob Schneider after the news. Stick around.